In this video, you want to find the circumference and area of this circle. In order to find the circumference and area, we need to know the radius or the diameter. Now, the radius or diameter would be the hypotenuse of this right triangle. Also, we know that these two legs of the right triangle are congruent. And so that means we have a 45-45-90. In a 45-45-90, the two legs are, let's call those the n side. The hypotenuse, if you remember, is the n root 2. And so that means this diameter is the n root 2 side. And we know that n is equal to 5 root 3. And so the diameter is equal to the n root 2 side. N is 5 root 3. So again, that's the n, and then times root 2. So the diameter would be 5 root 2 times root 3, and those square roots will multiply together to give us 5 root 6. Oops, 5 root 6 is the diameter. And now if 5 root 6 is the diameter, that means the radius is half as big. So the radius is 5 root 6 over 2. So now we can use this information to help us find the circumference and the area. Let's find circumference first, which we know to be pi times diameter. And in the previous slide, we knew that the diameter was 5 root 6. And so our circumference will be pi times 5 root 6, which we can rewrite in a number of different ways. My personal preference would be 5 pi root 6, leave the square root until the very end. And then, of course, we'd give this units. And if we were asked to approximate this, you could type 5 times pi times root 6 into your calculator, and that will give you 38.476 units. So there's our circumference. Now let's take a look at area. So in order to find the area, we'll need to use pi times radius squared. And of course, we know the radius from the previous slide. So we have 5 root 6 over 2 squared. And now dealing with such a complex thing squared is going to take a little bit of work. So let's go through it step by step. So we have 5 times. Now if we're squaring a fraction, we'd square the top part, 5 root 6. Oh, that 5 looks kind of cruddy, doesn't it? 5 root 6 squared over 2 squared. And now we'll deal with this numerator piece a little bit more. If I have 5 times root 6 squared, that's the same as 5 squared times root 6 squared. Which simplifies one step further to pi times 25 times 6 all over 4. Now I'm running out of room. Hold on just a sec. And 25 times 6 divided by 4. Well, 25 times 6 I know is 150. Over 4. But 150 over 4 can reduce to 75 over 2. So our exact area would be 75 over 2 pi square units. So that would be an exact answer. And if I did ask you for an approximate answer, then you'd type that into your calculator, and you would get approximately 117.810 square units. Again, both of these answers are correct. It just depends on whether you are asked for an exact answer, which would be this one, or an approximate answer, which would be that last one.